somewhere deep in time and space.
Hello there. I am Dr. Massengill Kotek, supreme mad scientist and space explorer, coming at you from the 31st century, according to your primitive Earth calendar. I am sending you this transmission today because I, alongside my lone companion here in outer space, Copabot here. Hello, Copabot.
I am Copabot. This unit comes complete with anti-gravitational.
All right. You're just lucky today. I got you in the fucking video, all right? Seriously, I've had nothing to do for you for like a year. You've just been sitting around. You fell on the ground. I had to put your vocabulator back together with some masking tape. I mean, seriously, I've had nothing to do with you for like a year. So just be happy you're in the video, you fucking painted Home Depot bucket. Anyway, I am Dr. Massengill Kotek, and I am coming at you, like I said, from the 31st century. Behind me, you will notice the most powerful phenomenon in the known universe. I am orbiting a super colossal black hole. There is more gravitational force behind me right now than there is in Pamela Anderson's underpants. Do you know what I'm saying? A black hole is indeed, it's like a woman. It lures you in, only to crush you like a tin can. It is very dangerous, and I am only able to survive here in my highly advanced space shuttle that only I can design.
Your primitive monkey brain cannot compute the gravity.
Well, why don't you just shut the fuck up, Copabot? Seriously, alright, fine, you know. The thing is that, you know, by the 31st century, hanging around the black hole really isn't a big deal. In fact, this was really the only real estate that I could afford in outer space, you know, that didn't come with a premium, you know. I mean, you ought to see, like, what real estate, like, beachfront property goes for on one of the moons of Jupiter. Expensive, really expensive real estate. But, you know, hanging around a black hole is cheap, you know. It's like in your time, if I were to buy a trailer park trailer and, like, that was, like, right next to, say, you know, a methamphetamine production home and maybe a Waffle House. It's about the same thing in 21st century terms here in the 31st century living around a black hole. Because, here, let me tell you, the gravitational pull on this thing just makes everything awkward. I mean, you should try to urinate next to the black hole. It's just like the urine just sprays everywhere. It's like a night of mad sex after you've just made love to a woman time after time after time again. And then your urine spray just like goes in five different directions. That's what it's like living next to a black hole.
The approximate odds of you getting laid are exactly 3,720 to 1.
What do you mean I don't get laid? I've been laid many times. Many times by space Martians and shit. Anyway, the reason I am coming at you people tonight is I wanted to tell you guys about these awesome figures, action figures that I just recently procured from your time that are just absolutely awesome. And, you know, unlike living next to a black hole, these were actually really hard to get. You know, engineering a space shuttle that can withstand the great massive gravitational pull of a black hole is nothing compared to having to find exclusives from fucking Walgreens. I don't know why that is, but anyway, I actually had to pay a premium for these because I did not find them at my local Walgreens. I looked a bunch of times. I kept going back to Walgreens, you know? How many times can you go to Walgreens? You look like a fucking creeper hanging around a drugstore. Like you're waiting for, like, underage girls to go in there and buy their birth control. You look like a serious fucking creeper hanging out in Walgreens. So I went to Walgreens so many times to try to find these awesome black hole figures. I never did. They always had the stupid fucking Tron figures. Who wants the Tron figures? I don't want the Tron figures. You know, one time when I was a little boy, I had a friend had a Betamax VCR. No kidding, a Betamax VCR. And he invited me over for the afternoon to view sci-fi movies. And I went over to his house expecting to see something, you know, really good, so like, say, Star Wars. And instead, we watched Tron. Can you imagine how disappointed I was, thinking that I was going to go over and see the adventures of Luke Skywalker in a galaxy far, far away? And instead, I got to see Jeff Bridges get sucked into an Apple IIc? Very disappointing film. Horribly overrated. I don't understand anyone who likes it. And why would you ever want to buy an action figure from that piece of crap movie? So all the Walgreens only have the goddamn Tron figures. I could not find the black hole ones. But anyway, so I found one finally at a local comic book galactic distributor, and I paid $30 for Vincent. I think he was like $20 at Walgreens, so I spent overpaid by $10 on Vincent here. And then, of course, if once I got Vincent, I had to get Maximilian.
You totally overpaid on that figure. You got figure scalp.
Yes, I know. Does Maximilian give you, like, an inferiority complex, Copobot? Because he's actually a cool-looking robot, unlike you, who looks like a flying 5-gallon bucket of shit. And you look like something that seriously we would put the dog shit in, back home on Earth. You know, we would put the dog shit in up here and it would stay down here so we wouldn't have to smell it. That's what you look like, Copobot. But anyway, here's Maximilian. I had to pay $42 for Maximilian here on Amazon.com, which really sucks. Anyway, let's take a look at these figures out of their boxes, okay?
There are figures all removed from their packaging and they look really, really fantastic. Look at Maximilian there, what an awesome looking action figure. He's got all of his like hand saws and shit. He's got multiple arms and he's on this really nice looking, premium looking stand. I must say, he comes with these like rockets. I don't know what the fuck these things are. Maybe they're like beaters or something, you know, so he can make a Duncan Hines kick perhaps. I'm not sure, it might be a hand attachment, I don't really remember. I've only seen this movie like 3 times in my whole life, but it's very, very cool. Anyway, so there's Maximilian, and here is Vincent, and he also comes with a shitload of accessories. Look at all this crap. You can actually like take like these little utility legs off and put this one in there so it looks like they're in the socket. Both of these are removable, and you can replace them with just the little plugs. If you guys can see that, if camera will focus. Stupid 21st century camera. Yeah, there it is. And these utility arms, of course, are removable. So he's very, very cool. And he comes on this stand, which is kind of a pain in the ass, I got to say. I don't know what it is with Diamond Select and stands. You know, I collect Art Asylum Star Trek ships, I think it was Diamond Select 2, and those stands are pieces of shit. But this stand is kind of a piece of shit too. But anyway, so there is Vincent there. I'll give you a little bit of a, 360 on him. So yeah, he looks very, very cool. As you guys can see, if camera focus for me, yeah, he looks very, very good. So anyway, there is Vincent and all of his glory. Of course, his head can go down into his little, he can hide like he's very scared, little turtle robot. Oh, very, very cool. So that is Vincent, and of course, once again, this is Maximilian, and let's get him just a little bit of a 360. Again, he's got some nice hand saws. Why don't you have hand saws, Copobot, you piece of shit? But anyway, there is Vincent, he's very cool. Of course, if I would have made hand saws on Copobot, he'd probably accidentally saw my peeper or something. That would be very, very bad. So there is Vincent here, Maximilian, I'm sorry. So he is very, very cool as well. So yeah, nice action figures. I think they were only $6.99 originally, $16.99 originally at Walgreens, but I had to pay scalper prices to get them because Walgreens sucks as far as their exclusives.
Alrighty, well, how Nick Max said, that's going to wrap up this edition of Plastic Planet. I hope you enjoyed the unboxing of those black hole figures. They're going to look really, really great in my collection, even though I live next to a black hole, as you know, and hanging collectibles and putting them on shelves is a little, you know, problematic, with the gravity and all that, so it's sort of a beast. They'll probably get broken, but anyway, they're very cool black hole figures exclusive from Walgreens that I totally got scalped on, but that's okay, because now I have them in my collection, and that's all that fucking matters. So, anyway, like I said, I hope you enjoyed that, and as Nick Mack says, how do they say it here on YouTube? Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to channel. Please subscribe to channel. Look at bullshit Nick Nack does to make videos fun and interesting and a little different every single week. And Nick Nack tries to give that to you, so all you got to do is subscribe. He doesn't ask for money. He doesn't have a bullshit Patreon account. There's no bullshit on this channel. Just subscribe to the Nick Nack Plastic Planet and enjoy the videos. That's all he asks. So, like I said, that's going to wrap things up here. What do you got to say, Copobot?
Fuck you.
Yeah, fuck you too. Fuck you too. Anyway, guys, that's it. I'll be back probably never because I'm a stupid character. But that's it on Plastic Planet. Later, and I enjoyed your company. You know, just between you and I, if I can be honest with you for a minute, I feel like we have, how you say it in your time, kinship, you know? Living next to black hole, a lot like, you know, buying, you know, full-size bag of candy corn at the store. You know, it seems like a good idea, no? You know, candy corn, it's a fall treat that can't be beat. Delicious, right? But, you know, after I have you about, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, like 10, you know, 10, 20 pieces of candy corn. It's like seriously living next to a black hole. You get all nauseous, you know, you all feel like shit, you know, you feel like you just like, you know, like you could seriously puke. Yeah, you know, I thought living next to black hole, you know, would be like badass, you know, like I get a lot of women, you know, with living next to black hole, you know. I go to the grocery store, you know, I hang on the fast food in the frozen food aisle. I wait for young lady to come down frozen food aisle, you know, in yoga pants, and I tell young lady, I say, hey young lady, I live on a space shuttle next to black hole, and I would think that would be badass, you know. They'd want to come see the black hole, and hopefully I could see, you know, perhaps an orifice on their body, you know, and get inside of their knickers. But no, the black hole does not attract the ladies. In fact, it's very, very bad.
3,000 astro cycles since a female has
been. Yeah, I know it's been like 30 years since I have lady up here in black hole, and she wasn't even human, but that's okay. That's okay. I have Pamela Anderson blow up doll. It's very nice.
Really,
why don't you eat shit, Copobot? Seriously, just fuck off. God, you fuck off. I mean, seriously, fuck off. Get the fuck out of here, Copobot.